If this isn't about power and it's about science, it would be great if politicians stopped treating us all like children, even though children are actually the ones who are barely affected by this. What happens when people won't listen to coronavirus lockdowns and spoken word laws that go against your fundamental freedoms? You could do what Melbourne, Australia did and completely lock down your population, installing a mandatory curfew punishable by arrest.
Get off of me! Get off!
Let go of your vest.
Let go of your
vest.
He's fucking choking me! He's choking me! What the fuck?
Let go of
your vest. Fuck off me! What the fuck?
It's a man on a girl and you
get
choked
off
her.
For
what? For a mask? For not having a mask? Look how pathetic you are! She doesn't have a mask! Are you serious?
Things must be really out of hand in Australia for things to be this bad, you would think. Australia has taken the extreme measures of a 6-week lockdown due to having shocking COVID numbers. As of this recording, in their country of almost 26 million people, Australia has a whopping, brace yourselves now, 421 deaths. During the 24-hour period for Tuesday, they conducted almost 39,000 tests with a shocking 290 positive cases. That's a frightening 0.75% positivity rate. Now, you might be laughing at this, but it's not so funny for the citizens of Australia. New Zealand might just be worse, however. And no, I don't mean in case numbers or death, I mean the insanity. New Zealand postpones election to October as coronavirus flares up. This flare-up brings New Zealand's active cases to an overall 90. Yes, 90, with a total number of 22 deaths for the country of 5 million people. There's only 6 people in hospital for COVID there. The Premier of British Columbia put out a call for celebrities to help push his propaganda. That's exactly what it is. He didn't ask for doctors, of course, that's too simple. But luckily, some actors came to the rescue on his behalf. Listen to actor Ryan Reynolds inject some hard facts into this discussion.
Premier Horgan, Ryan Reynolds here. I got your message about the thing. In young folks in BC, yeah, they're partying. Which is, of course, dangerous, and they probably don't know that thousands of young people aren't just getting sick from coronavirus, that they're also dying from it, too.
Thousands of people aren't just getting sick from coronavirus, they're also dying from it, too. Now, I love Ryan Reynolds, I think he's hilarious, but that is just a ridiculous fear-mongering claim. At best, it's extreme hyperbole to get people to comply. In Canada, 10 people under the age of 30 have died for coronavirus. 10. And if we want to go out of our way and give him the benefit of the doubt on this, we can include the US numbers, where 291 people under 25 years old have died. And as of the making of this video, that's about half the amount of people in the same age range who have died of pneumonia this year. That's just 130 more deaths than the flu in this year. So why aren't there celebrity PSAs for the flu every year? I don't get it. Why isn't Seth Rogen telling you to stay home and smoke weed in the winter to avoid catching pneumonia, like he's doing right now for coronavirus? Stay home and get wrecked, kids. Now, I'm not against weed at all, but that's a moronic statement to be championed by a political leader. It's all nonsense. Now, I'm not saying throw the sick people into retirement homes, Governor Cuomo style. I'm saying this constant fear-mongering has gone way too far. We get it. Don't be stupid. Don't cough and spit on each other. Definitely no singing at church. And we're already sitting 6 feet apart, so putting on a mask walking into a restaurant only to take it off when we sit down, that doesn't make any sense. We all know it. Wearing a mask when I walk into the gym is required, but the virus suddenly goes away when I'm working out. Right. If this isn't about power and it's about science, it would be great if politicians stopped treating us all like children, even though children are actually the ones who are barely affected by this. Thanks for watching. Hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our videos, and go to maskexemption.ca to get your mask exemption cards. You might want them.